World Cred Challenge 2012 here in Guam in the Oceania region, and I'm here with Mrs. Petra Sörling, ITTF Vice President. And I know that this competition is close to your heart as it is to mine. So give me your impression about the 2012 version.
Well, this is the sixth time I attend this event, and as you said, it's really close to my heart. And it's hard to say, but it's improving every year, and this year as well. The 2012 version here in Guam is really well organized, and it was a challenge for the first time in Oceania to have this event, but I really think they succeeded.
And it's been a tremendous effort also from the local government of Guam, and really we're hitting here with this competition now at such a tremendous level, and much of the credit should really go to the ITTF staff behind this event as well. Raul Calin from Spain being the competition manager and the driving force for this competition.
Of course, you're taking my words now, because you're really putting the finger on the spot, because this is really something else to organize, of course, for the ITTF, but this is also how we actually have this event as a development, as a part of the development program as well, because this is really how to improve an association with the help of the ITTF. And as you said, without Raul Calin, this event would never take place.
So if we look at the global picture of table tennis now, this event was put in at one time back in 2002 to really try to develop table tennis from an excellence point of view and development. We have all the six continents here. We have an ITTF Hopes team that I think is adding some spice to this competition. How do you see the continental development if you look at players' development?
Well, it's a huge difference now if you compare to like for 10 years ago. We could see that this kind of events really put forward the excellence of continents like Latin America and Africa. So now they are really able to challenge also Europe at least, but probably also Asia in the future.
There's been, and we come back to that a few times, the Asian dominance in table tennis, and let's talk about Europe, the continent that has in some cases been a little bit up and down, but there is such a need nowadays to try to develop players maybe in a different way, and being in part of the executive board in Sweden, you know firsthand how important it is to have good players.
Yes, it's a struggle to see how the gap actually is not decreasing in the way to compare Europe against Asia. But I do think we need to start on the national level to have something like the Hopes team, and then to continue on a continental level, and then finally at the world level. Now we actually showed how it could be in the case of our World Hopes team in the ITTF. But I do think to decrease the gap, we need to start on the national level first.
And it's starting earlier, and that's such an important part. And talk about the Hopes team a little bit. It's an ITTF relatively new program. It's growing rapidly, I would say. There's been some really, really nice players here, a bit younger. And do you think the program is working?
Yes, I do think so. I remember when we spoke about it some 4 or 5 years ago as a vision, and it's always very nice when you see the vision comes true. And I think it's here to stay. And but I do hope that we can link it more together with the national and the continental level as well. But I'm very happy to see how it works and how we can actually put players together from all over the world in a team like we do with the World Hopes team.
And that's it. International solidarity is one of the more important things also in this competition, which is more than a competition. It is a challenge, and we're here at the 2012 World Cred Challenge in Guam. Thank you.